This is Walter Schrode, your roving reporter at KSRC Radio in Socorro, New Mexico. We have with us this afternoon Mr. Ronnie Zamora, the Socorro patrolman that, while chasing a car, found himself in an area about 2 miles west of Socorro and 1 mile east of KSRC Radio Station, at which time he reports he came upon an unidentified object resting on four legs. That as he drew closer, the object took off with a loud roar, spouting blue-red flame, and disappeared in the sky. A great number of cars and Socorro people have gathered here in front of the studios of KSRC to catch a glimpse of Mr. Zamora as he arrives and welcome him with their car horns. Mr. Zamora, after coming upon this object, just what did happen?
I went up that little road for about half a mile, I guess. Came up to this little parking meter there on the side of the road, and I caught a glance out on the window. Up to my left, there was this white object on the ground. So I thought it might be a car that had turned over. So I also heard the real big Harry went out there to investigate. I thought maybe somebody would be hurt. That time I saw this white egg-shaped looking object. Something like an egg to me. Yeah, from the distance I watched, it looked like an egg to me. About the size of a car, I think, someone said. Yes, sir, it looked like a car that had turned over. It was a size of a car. And did it all have markings on of any kind that you noticed? Yes, it did. Not the most far, I didn't see the markings. When I went up closer to it, I did see the markings. And someone said that the markings that you saw was an upside down V with three lines running through it.
Yes, sir,
no. harsh, loud roaring sound and after it got up in the air about 20 feet while the sound seemed to disappear, the sound was disappeared in a very, very quiet place. And now, the markings are left on the ground. Now, the reports that I have had, and I haven't had a chance to go out and take a look in the winds yet, see if probably was a lot of that anyway, was that there was a deep indentations in the ground approximately 10 inches wide and 6 to 8 inches deep. About 15 feet apart. That is a direct report.
You know,
I would say it was about 19 feet apart of the grid. And were there any other prints, like footprints around the area when you were making the investigation?
There were some prints, but I wouldn't know if there were footprints or anything.
Couldn't identify them as actually being a footprint in the indentation. I mean, somebody might have walked there, or somebody might have walked there.
Somebody walked around there because there was, when I got there, there was nobody around there.
Yes. Now, that was, according to a report from